Good day. It's a beautiful day. I thank God for life. And I thank God for every single thing and every day that passes by. We have a lot to thank God for. We thank God for shelter. We thank God for provision. We thank God, most importantly, for our lives. Some of us are sick. Some are in the dying bed. Some are giving up just at this moment that we are speaking. But you are opportune to sit and listen to a word of wisdom. To sit and listen to what God has in stock for us. Welcome to the Keys and Consulting Platform, where we edify ourselves on relationship, marriage, addiction, and so many other issues. It's a wonderful day. It's a wonderful day, midweek. But yes, God is powerful. I'm Jude Emmanuel Kebo Matita. Today, I came to talk on something. I know so many people are facing these situations or are in a dilemma when it comes to the topic that I want to talk about today. It's a kind of long-distance relationship. But in this sense, it's a long-distance relationship with people from two different continents. Not from Africa, but I want to specify Europe and America. I've had issues a lot on my desk on this. But I believe that God, in His infinite mercy and wisdom, will give me a direction today. Let me use the wisdom of God and not my own carnal knowledge. For this is important. My brothers and sisters, I'm addressing these because many has come to me. But what's so urgent is that I got a mail yesterday and I decided to address it. The person that sent me the mail, please, I beg your indulgence. You listen to this video, and I hope it helps you. Now, the person said that, sir, I have been following up most of the things and your videos in YouTube. I've subscribed to your platform. And to tell you the truth, it has helped me a lot. And I'm still building myself. I thank God for your wisdom. You see, I have a particular problem. I dated a lady. We dated a long time ago. And you see, we separated, we parted ways. The lady is now in US, but I'm in Europe. When I called you, I had the opportunity to talk with you. I will tell you the specific country that I am. But for now, no, I'm in Europe. I'm resident, and I have a permanent resident in Europe. I'm not illegal, as I must say. The lady is also resident in US. And she has the US citizenship. After all these years when we parted ways, we reconnected. And I decided to take the relationship to another level. Knowing that having something in mind that I've dated her for some time when we're young, and I believe I knew her, and that is okay for me. Now, we made a traditional wedding. I went and met the family, paid the bride price, and everything. So we are actually planning to be together. Now that is where my problem comes. You see, I have a job and I feel I'm comfortable where I am. But my wife too also has a job there. She has a career and a big one at that. She's at the apex of her career. She earns way more than me. And this has also brought some issues in our relationship. A lot of issues. I feel that I don't know her anymore. She don't respect me. Most often, I just feel choked up in the relationship. I feel she detects every single thing that we need to do. She doesn't value my opinion, and she feels her position financially is stronger than mine. And she feels she has gone up to the echelon when it comes to education. And I'm just somebody. At times I feel that she considers me as if I'm not intelligent enough. Now I am confused. We have several arguments. Each time we talk on the phone, it's one thing or the other. I'm just so confused. But when we dated before, it was so sweet, and that is why I reconnected with her. Knowing that since we have a relationship, we have a history, it was just a quest for a good life that separated us, not actually that we had issues. But now I'm seeing something different. I thought things would be the same, that is why I knew her before, and I got married to her. But I think something has happened along the line, but I don't know. And now she's thinking that I need to move over to come to US, that she cannot leave US and come, that I will be the one to move. But I'm scared the way her character is. I don't know what to do, sir. Please, I need your advice. I need your input on this issue. I need to take a decision, but that decision is my life. If I made a mistake now, it would be devastating to me. I once made a mistake, so I don't want to make that mistake anymore. I'm the time of my life that all I need is peace, not arguments around me all the time. Help me, sir. Thank you very much. I'll call you. I've seen your contact. I'll contact you and give you any other information that you need. May God bless you. Thank you. Yes, that is the situation, and it's something that I want to address. He's not the only one, there are so many others. But we are talking to this particular direction based on somebody that's already married traditionally. Before making this video, we had a talk on phone, and there are certain questions that I asked him and gave him certain directions. But I said it's better I share it with you guys, for I know a lot have the same situation moving. A lot of guys have left Europe to America because they found love. At the end of the day, most of them, they end up not staying with that same woman that they left for. Most of them have issues. A lot of them have known a lot, have friends that have suffered that fate. Friends that abandoned their permanent residence in Europe and traveled to US. And of course, because they have a wife, they have to start from zero. They have to depend on the wife. They have to start everything. It's not an easy thing to leave from one country to another. have an experience in that. So I'm speaking from a point where I also have an experience. I left one country, though it was in Europe, to another. Many years back, when I got married, I know how it worked. I know the situation. So I'm talking from experience and with the wisdom that God has given to me. First, my brother, you see, we always say this thing that I dated her before. She was my girl long time ago. Situations changed and we found ourselves in different countries because we want to have a better life. Not that we actually had a problem. So many are faced with that situation. But what we fail to understand is time and situation changes the character of people. That is what you do not understand. That is why sometimes it's needed. Courtship is needed in any relationship. It might be an old girlfriend that you had, old relationship that you had. But you see, 5 years, 10 years down the line, in a different environment, it's something huge. It's something that can change people. The situation might change people. The environment might change people. Now, this your woman, for instance, is in the US. The way they operate there is different from the way you operate in Europe or in Africa that you people were before you traveled. So there are so many situations that has changed. That has changed her. Her mentality has changed. Education, she's more educated than the way you left her. So many things has changed. She has changed friends. She has influence from friends. She has influence from the society. That is why you need, even if you thought that this is the relationship, you needed to trade in a different dimension. You needed to be in courtship with her. Try to see if it works. Try to look at her character again. Now you are complaining that she doesn't respect you. Yes. Those things come because you are in from a different dimension. You are in Europe. The way things function here is different from the way things function in the US. That's the fact. You know, we also left Africa where there is this thing, we have a cultural thing that binds us together. We have our traditions that binds us together. But you see, those traditions don't really apply here. Situations don't really apply here. Yeah, you have opportunity. Women have opportunity. She has developed herself. She has built herself in a particular level, a particular dimension. Now, that goes with her character too. So it is something that you are supposed to know. But yes, you did not take that into consideration before you went and did your traditional things. And now, from what you told me on the phone, you are scared. You are scared. Not only you are scared because of society. Now, the first thing that you told me is, what will people say? My brother, you can't rely on the things that people will say. What will my family say? You can't rely on the things that your family will say. What you rely on is your happiness. Are you comfortable in that relationship? Is that the way you want to spend the rest of your life? Is it better to start something and you end it than to enter into something that you do not know how it will end? Now, there might be a way to work it out. There might be a way to talk with her. Every single thing is communication. Communicate with her. Try to look at her from her present state. Not look at her, not judge her based on who she was. Because she is never the same. Likewise, you. There are things that, as you see, yeah, I'm speaking to you. I'm talking to you based on the information that you gave me. I don't know her own side of the story. I don't know what she thinks. She might have her own side of the story. She might think different. So the information that I'll give her will be based on what information that you give me. You know, remember, I can give you information. I can advise you on a path that you can take based on the information that you give. If you are truthful to yourself, fine, the information will be good. But if you are telling lies, let me tell you something. No matter what I say, it will not apply to you. Because if you are telling lies, I'll be giving you an advice based on the lies that you told, based on the facts that you told. It is from the facts that we use to tell you, to give you information, just as I told you on phone. Now, I want you to look deep into yourself and ask yourself, man, the charity begins at home. Let me examine myself first before you go to the lady. Am I the same? When we're dating, what was my idea? How did I look life? How did I look at life? Is it the same? Is it the same? The prospects, my aspirations in life, what I wanted, what I want to become. Have I achieved my dreams? Ask ask yourself that question. Try to look inside, try to look inward. Most often we fail to look at ourselves. We rush to blame the other person. But do you have that same character? Are you the same person that she also dated years back? Are you the one? Are you that same guy? If things have changed, then things have changed. So you need to examine yourself, look at the changes that occurred in you, and try to equate that change, try to balance those changes with the changes that you know she's going through or she has. Have you talked with her? Have you had communication? Because from what you said, there is also a communication problem that you don't communicate. Most of the time, people are arguing, you know, there is something about distance relationship. I made a video and I spoke about it. Distance relationship, you must have the guts for it. You must know the language of your partner. Some partners want to have their man by their side or their woman by their side. And if they don't have that thing they have as their strength, touch. If they can't feel you, they can't touch you. They become agitated. A person like that will always pose problems to you because you are living in different areas. So you need to know the love language. Go back to the video that I talk about love language. You need to know the love language of your wife. What is her love language? Can she accommodate distance? Because sometimes you can say that she's not respecting you, she's not, because she's stressed up. Might be because the distant thing is not working, it's not actually working for her. So you also need to look at that dimension. But you are the one to find out what's her love language. Go back to that video and find her love language. Look at love language and see what you want. Look at what you want if she can accommodate distance. Because with distance, there's bound to be friction. Now, is it the person that likes you to communicate frequently? Is she the communication type that will call you all the time, wants to know your position, wants to know what you do? Because I've said, when it comes to distance relationship, at one point in time, there's a lot about trust. And trust goes with you when you are saying you give your day in, day out information to your partner. Your partner needs to know where you are going. At this point in time, every single minute they call your partner will be able to say that my wife is at this particular position. My husband is at this position. Are you in that direction? Because if you are not in that direction, you need to work on it. So, but first and foremost, I want you to examine yourself and look at your own love language. What do you actually want? What do you prefer in relationship? Examine yourself, re-examine yourself. It might not be too late. Re-examine yourself and have a talk. There's nothing more than dialogue. All you need is to dialogue. Yeah, you will say, she don't want to dialogue, she don't want to listen. Any proposal I place in front of her, she rejects it, she don't want to take my ideas. Okay, I do understand that. But then, what about options? She's your wife. Go and meet him. If it doesn't work on the phone, go buy a ticket, look for vacation, go and meet her in US and put her down and talk to her. You people should talk. You are family. You are already married. Traditionally, that's why the Bible recounts marriage. Marriage starts from there. You go to court only to put those things together, to find the law to be on your side when so many things happen. You go to church only to tell God that, oh, this is the woman that I have chosen. So marriage is when you go and meet your family, the family of the woman, and you pay them and you do the necessary traditional rites that the family wanted. So for now, she is your wife, traditionally, and we know that's your wife. But now you need to talk as wife. Do you people have the same goals? Do you people have the same goals? What does she stand for? Yeah, all these things you need to talk. From the information that you give, that you gave when I spoke to you, when I spoke with you, what happened is financially people have some financial issues because you did not even talk financial issues before you involve yourself in the marriage. You do not know the stake of your woman, her investment or something like that. Now, something also came up. You want to go there and you want to be with a woman. Now you are thinking of going to court. Now you are developing a cold feet because something is coming up, prenuptial something, that was something that just developed here. The woman wants to know or to declare assets or things like that. He said, you should talk about it. Now you are afraid that, and you have something different in your mind. Why would she even bring up that idea that we have to talk about the properties we had before we are getting married? Now, this comes down to one thing. Does she really trust you? Or do you really trust her to make that agreement? Now, she is proposing that thing as per what you said, or you are proposing as per what you said, but now, It might be she might not have an intention, any intention, but she just needs protection. Maybe she also has been there and seen things that ladies have suffered a lot. And at the end of the day, when they got married to the husband, something came up, the husband just benefited. I knew of a situation when the husband did not do anything, the lady did everything. At the end of the day, the lady need to sell the house and still give half of the money to the man. But the man did nothing, but because they were married. So you see, some women now are becoming afraid of situations like that because the society make those situations. So sometimes they want to define things before you get married to them. That is why in this Western world, we need to sit, we need to talk to each other and find out those little things. Don't ignore those things. Those things are red flags. You need to talk about them. You need to talk about them. Then there is this something that I need to talk to you about. You see, the Bible tells us that a man will leave his father and mother and get himself a wife. Which therefore means when you get yourself a wife, that wife will accommodate that wife. Accommodation is important. The Bible spells it out that you are the head of the family, that you are supposed to provide for your family. You provide for your family. Yes, I do understand situations might change things. Especially when we're living in a society where there are so many different types of situations that we find ourselves. But now ask yourself this question. You came to Europe. You've been to Europe. You've struggled to have a permanent resident in Europe. Now, based on the fact that I live in this Europe and most often their policies are almost the same. And from one country to the other, especially EU countries. You have a permanent resident, it means you can stay. And after a certain amount of years, you can apply for their nationality. Now, if you not apply for the nationality yet, or it's not yet time, you've not yet qualified, I know it's about 5 years, and if you're working in most countries for you to apply, and you think that you want to go and settle in US, when you go to settle in US, what happens? What happens? You are going there to start from afresh. Whether you like it or not, you have to depend on that lady. She is there. You have to go and stay under his roof, under her roof. It is another thing. You must need to know the woman that you got married to. You can come and stay under the roof of a woman, and the woman will always remind you every day that she is the one paying the rent. She is the one you are staying under her. Now, you need to understand there are consequences in these things. And when you go there, remember, with a permanent resident, you are not going there to pick up a resident in the U.S. No, it's not an EU country. So when you go there, there's an immigration problem that you have to start to deal with. You have to deal with the immigration problem. You have to make yourself legal. It is not easy. So you have to depend on her to make yourself legal in that particular position. So is that what you need to think deep with that before you say that we want to relocate? I've got situations in my hand when people relocated and they had to maybe go there and decided to seek asylum. Someone decided to need papers or the woman decided to get married to them. It is not as easy as you think. You need to do all those things. And at one point in time, you need to know the mind of the woman. The woman will always remind you at one point in time that, look, I took you from Europe and I brought you here. And I gave you papers and I gave you everything. Look, it is our society. The society is like that. We use those things against each other, which is wrong. Which is totally wrong. But you need to look very well before you leap. That is what you need to know. So many have gone there and frustrated at the end of the day. They abandoned the woman. They have abandoned their permanent resident. They have stayed out of this place, maybe for 6 months. Without coming back to the country, when they come back, they abandon everything. And what? They cannot come back to take up their permanent residence anymore. So, they are in a fix. Some of them stay in the U.S. for about 5 years, only searching for documentation. They could not have it. But when they were in Europe, they had their documentation. They had every other thing. But because they had to relocate, because they had to meet their wife, it changes everything. Or they had to meet their husband. It changed everything. You have to start from somewhere. You go back almost as if you left Africa and came to the Western world. You must understand that is what you will face. That is what you face. So you need to talk to her. You need to you have a visit. You need to visit her. Look at her environment and see the way. Look at the way she interacts and operates with you. Now you've already started complaining when you've not gone there, but now that complaint is from a distance. My advice is to you is that be together. She can come from holiday, but most importantly, I want you to go there. You, the man, if you in their intention, as you said, is to go to US, then you need to go there and stay there even for 3 months. Be with her. You will try to see her character, try to work on her character, try to know what she thinks. You can't know it from a distance. She has her own things too. Might be against you, but she has not said it to you. So you need to go there. You need to stand down and look at the situation. And my brother, the best thing for you to do before you relocate, let me tell you something. Trust me on this. You need to stay in Europe. And when you are qualified to apply for their nationality, apply for their nationality and get that nationality. If you think to relocate in America, you need it. Now, you need it. Ask the question is, why do you need it? You need it because with a European passport, you can at least stay legal for 3 months. You can come after 3 months, you go back. Then you already have a base. Even if you go there and things becomes different, what happened is you can easily, with the passport, you can stay as long as you want in any other country. You come back, you are a citizen of that country. It's your country. You're just like you're coming back home. So it will not change anything in you. So the most important thing that I want you to have now is to relax. Don't relocate to America yet. Make sure you have a passport. Make sure you have nationality in the country that you are in, the European country. Though I know the country where, for the video's sake, I will not say the country, but it's in Europe, in Central Europe. So I want you to understand that it is important for you to have your nationality. Forget the pressure that the woman might put you in, that no, I need you now, I need you, I want you to come, I want you to do this, we are married. Forget that pressure. You are a man, there are certain things that you need to know. Your foundation must be deep-rooted, and your foundation should come with a base that the woman will also understand that you have a base. That even you come to US and you apply to change your status or you apply for something, you are coming there to apply as a European citizen that wants to stay in US. It's different. Most of those procedures are different. Then there's another thing that I want you to do. Career path. It is different with Europe and that of US. But there are certain things that you can do. Go there, stay there for some time. Know the things that you want to do. If you want to take up a career, it's the education that you want, a particular career path that you want. Look at the roadmap. How you will do it. You can still do it. Most of those courses, most of those training are online. Most certification things are online. You can go there and you see courses that you want. You enroll. You come back, even if you are in your country in Europe. There are online things. Work them online and you start writing the examinations. Study and write the examination. If it is certification that you need, if it is board that you need, write it. Study and write it and have it. So by the time you are ready with your passport, by the time you are ready to move, you already have every documentation and the certificates and the accreditation that you need in US. You already have every single thing. So when you come, it will be easy for you to assimilate and enter into that society. That is what you need to know. But when it comes to the character of your woman, when you are telling me that the woman doesn't respect you, these things might come, as I said. You need to know the love language of your wife. It might also come out of distress because she's feeling that she got married and she's still staying single. You don't want to get married and stay single. She don't want to have that. So it might come because of that. All those arguments might come because of that. But you need to go and meet her and talk with her. Now, this is very simple. But you need to think. I've got friends that went to US like that and they suffered. Some for 5 years before even having documentation. They could not work. They had to rely on the woman. And because of that pressure, they had to separate. Separation is very easy because you have pressure. The woman has pressure. You also have pressure. There's pressure coming from both directions. So we must understand these things. So you need to look at yourself and find out what you want, what you need. Re-examine yourself and see the things that you accommodate. Let me tell you something. Love is sacrifice. Love is not emotional as we want it to be, as we see it. So we need to sacrifice. What do you sacrifice in that relationship? These are the things that you need to sacrifice. There are sacrifices you need to make as a man. God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son. His only begotten son. He sacrificed his son for love. What are you willing to let go? So you must sacrifice something. You must sacrifice something. The woman must sacrifice something. But you are the man. You have the responsibility. Look, I always say that what the man carries is far greater than what they understand. The Bible tells you that you have to love your woman just as Jesus. And use the example as Jesus. But Jesus loved the woman. Jesus loved up and died for us. Since despite the fact that he was doing the things which were right, we were still saying many bad things about him. Now, which therefore means, and God is telling you to love a woman just like Jesus did for us. Don't you think it's a burden? It means that the woman will say things against you. The woman will do things. The woman will ache you. The woman will do so many bitter things. But you still need to forgive her. So, marriage is commitment. It's more than that love, that emotional love that we think. It's sacrifice. The love in marriage is sacrificial love. Now, you need to make sacrifices. But don't make it foolishly. Don't make it foolishly. You need to make sacrifices, wise decisions. Just as I said, go there and stay with her. Look at the environment. Try to build up yourself a career. Try to build up yourself education-wise and everything. So before going to US, you have every other thing. Try to make sure when you are leaving this place, you have a passport. You have a nationality. So you have a fallback position. It's always nice to have plan B in everything that you do. So that will be your plan B. Anything happens, you have your plan B. And it will also ease the process for you to have a resident in US. At least you're a European citizen. It is different from when you are from Africa. Yeah, I don't know most often about their process, those are immigration things, but I believe it's a bit easier than you, somebody just coming from Africa. It's different. You're a European citizen. So it's different. I believe and I hope the information that I have given will help you. Will help you. Will help you. If you still have issues when you visit her and when you talk, how to know yourself, talk about finances, talk about emotions, talk about family issues, put everything on top of the table. And you talk. You people should be comfortable. The woman should be comfortable. You be comfortable. Comfortability breeds trust. When you're comfortable in a relationship, it breeds trust. You must be open to her. Open. Express yourself. You see, sometimes the things that she will propose are just because she needs security. It's just because she wants security. She also needs to be secured. We should also look at these things. A woman also needs security. She needs to be secured that you are the woman, that you are the man for him. For her, she needs to be secured that despite the fact that she has some investments or whatsoever, those investments, you recognize that these are your investments and you treat her equally. She needs to be secured that she will not go and sign something with you. Then at the end of the day, you say you don't want her and they have to split her property, what she has worked for. Same with you. You both need to be secured in that environment. You both need to be secured in that relationship. Please, I want you to understand that that relationship, marriage, is between you and her, two people coming together. The Bible said the man will leave the father and mother and get himself a wife, which means the equation for two and three, the equation for three and more, God removed that thing out of the equation. He removed it out of the equation. So it's between you and her. So you need to work on yourself. You need to work on yourself. Take it easy on yourself and take it easy on her. All of us have pressure. Pressure from this environment, because the environment alone is pressure. There's a lot of pressure in this place. She goes to work, you don't even have time for yourself. So you see, that pressure is getting a toll on us too. So I want us to understand that we need to relax, accommodate ourselves, talk. Sometimes it's good to make jokes. Jokes. It keeps everything up. Talk and laugh with her. Make her your friend. You see, friends talk about everything. Friends don't care. They just say their things. You must be comfortable with your woman. How comfortable are you? When she goes to the toilet or she's on the seat board and making caca or something, what have you done? Can you be comfortable sitting there? And she's doing that. Can you do that? Can you do that? If he gas, poo, da, 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 can you stand it? Can you do that? Because if you are able to accommodate these little things that I'm talking about, that is where that relationship is going to friendship. That somebody will just sit there and move his clean up. I will say, my man, how is that? And you laughed at it. You see, if you don't find a way to go to that level, sometimes when you talk, some people feel that, he doesn't respect me, while he throws slants. Sometimes those slants are important. Sometimes it's important. We talk about every time we detox our system. Don't you feel that we need to also detox our system with laughter, with smile, with jokes? It's important. Be fun. Try to create fun. You, women love fun time. Whether you like it or not, they will just smile. They'll look at you and they smile. And those are the things that they remember. Play with her. Don't be too serious. Don't be too serious. When you are too serious in a relationship, it becomes so formal. So formal. And when it's so formal, you become uncomfortable. Both parties become uncomfortable. Relax your body. Relax. Relax. Let's relax. Feel free. When you are talking with her, feel free. Don't be so serious and don't put meaning into things. Don't put meaning into things. Allow the things to play along. Don't put meaning into it. Allow things to play along. We should allow things to play along. We should not prejudge people. We should not judge intentions. You don't know somebody's intention. You might not say this person did this because he has this reason and that's his reason. You are not in his heart. You are not in her heart. Sometimes we prejudge things and draw conclusions where we're wrong. The person might just say something and just move in. Just like my grandmother said at the talk the pass. The person might just be going. But you are there, you are saying that you are putting meaning into things. Most times we do that, especially in distant relationship. We put meaning into things. You call her, she's not pick. She's not picking her. Why? Maybe he has a girl now. Maybe she has another man. Look at this time. Look at the time. No, please. Just wait for her explanation. Wait, she might call and say, I saw your missed call. Wait, let us give her an explanation. If she doesn't give her an explanation, she doesn't feel obliged to give her an explanation, then you know there's problems. Then there's something deeper. You see, sometimes we see red flags, but we still go there. You know it. You've seen your flags. You've seen the red flags. But I want you to visit her. Take these steps and find out. When we take each step in life, we evaluate afterwards that, okay, I've done this. What is the outcome? We try to reevaluate the situation. So I want you to take these steps and each step you take, evaluate the situation. So most people are in this situation. Most. I just want you to know that there is more to life. There is more to life. There is happiness. There is peace of mind. Remember, God lives in us. When your conscience is wrong, when something disturbs your conscience, know that your conscience, God lives in your conscience and God talks to you. There's one thing that I always say, one verse in the Bible that I always love. John 8:32. That the truth and nothing but the truth will set you free. Be truthful to yourself first and be truthful to your wife. Be truthful, you the wife. Be truthful to your husband. Be truthful. Say the truth no matter the situation. You see, truth is important. It changes things. The woman might be annoyed, but you've said what you've said. The man might be annoyed, but she has said what she said. And that is the truth. At the end of the day, you will come around. Because God has a way to bring people together. God has a way to turn around things which are truthful. That is why God lives in your conscience. Because when you do something and you discover you don't have peace, your conscience disturbs you. If moment you are not comfortable, it means that there is something wrong in that thing. But when you do something which is right, let me tell you something. You have peace of mind because your conscience will be at peace. Most times when our conscience disturbs us, it's because God is telling us that what we are doing is wrong. Search yourself. God speaks to us. in every situation speaks to us. He exposes things to us that most often we don't want to see. So my brother, I want you to look. Sometimes we look, but we refuse to see. But I want you to look and see. Don't refuse. Look at it genuinely. Shakespeare said, a man in love and that same time reason is hard to find. I know it is. But you see, this love is not emotional. When you are emotional, you don't think. But when that love is deep-rooted with sacrifice, is deep-rooted with commitment, you will think. It's emotional love that you don't think. Emotional love is just emotions. Just you envisage the things that you want, and that's what you want. You just want to feel good. But you see, the love that God talks about, the love that comes to marriage, that love is embedded with sacrifice. And that particular love, you think. Because any sacrifice you make, you think about it. Because there are repercussions in the things you do. So in every sacrifice you think. So the love that you have when it comes to marriage is a love that you think, and you think positively. Be positive. Be positive. Just like I said, the woman might just be yearning now, doing things based on her own love language. She needs you by her side. That's why she's behaving that way. So rediscover herself. And when you discover herself, don't fail to contact me. Make sure you say the things that you need to say, the right things that you are supposed to say. God, in His infinite mercy, will bless us. I want us to share this video. It will help a lot of us, especially when we have relationships on different continents. It will help us examine ourselves. Those that are married or are struggling to get married, they are thinking that, how will I do this? It's a path that I have given. It might be small, but little things matters. Just try it and see what God has in store for us. Send it to individuals. Subscribe. And don't forget, I'm doing this for now. It's knowledge. It's free. From December, it will not be free. But God that placed it in my soul, placed it in my heart, made it possible for us to have this wisdom. As I said, may God use me. Thank you very much, and have a good and a blessed day.